All right, so what are some of the top niches for Shopify dropshipping? Before I get started, I wanted to show you guys. This is the results for the month so far, wrapping up this month. Nothing too crazy. We've had better months, but this has been pretty much consistent for the last few months with not a lot of work because obviously we have a team that, you know, helps me run my store. You know, there's a lot of people that talk about different niches, different things when it comes to Shopify dropshipping and all these different strategies, but when it comes down to it, not a lot of people can show the results. So I just wanted to be transparent with you guys and show you guys, you know, that we're in the trenches and we're actually trying and testing different things. So some of the things that we're going over and some of the strategies that I'm sharing with you guys are actually legit. So for some of you guys that don't know me, my name is Juan Valdez, and if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button, join the VFAM. The VFAM is a community and a movement of people that are aspiring to do a lot more than what society has offered us to do. There was an article that was dropped by Shopify themselves in Black Friday. I actually posted about it in Snapchat and Instagram when it first came out, but this article was going over a few different things. One of the main things being that around the Black Friday and that Black Friday weekend, Shopify had actually done processed over $1 billion in its platform. You know, obviously huge month, huge weekend. And actually this year, they're expecting it to be, you know, a bigger weekend. You guys can actually check it out. I'll post a link to the article below so you'll be able to go ahead and, you know, read a little bit about what happened this Black Friday. But what I wanted to kind of show you guys is Shopify is actually dropping specific data that you guys can actually use and analyze yourselves. And it's actually data that even I use to analyze to kind of get ideas, you know, the difference between how many people are using mobile versus desktop. They showed a lot of different things where people were buying from, different countries and all around the world, where the traffic was coming from. They were showing where the people were getting like high conversion rates compared to, you know, email, search options, social media, and all these different, you know, methods of getting traffic and some of the statistics. But what they also showed was some of the top sales categories and some of the biggest buys, right? And they broke it down between these different categories. And I wanted to kind of share this with you guys to kind of go over and break it down, because when it comes to Shopify dropshipping, there's many different niches you can get into. And obviously there's tons of niches where you can make a lot of money. You know, you can have your general store, you can have your niche store. They're both great options. But I figured I'd share this article with you guys so you guys can see some of the previous data from the last year, so you can kind of get an idea of what areas, you know, or niches you should be looking into. Now, it looks like one of the biggest spaces was apparel, right? Clothing. It looks like clothing absolutely crushed it. I can see that happening. We have some experience with apparel, so I know that for a fact it is a niche that has a lot of potential. Obviously, there's different, you know, there's tons of different stores that are selling clothing, all these different, you know, social media influencers that are selling clothing. So obviously it's a space where there is a lot of room, you know, to obviously make money in. Now, within clothing, you can sell, you know, cat clothing, pet clothing, any kind of clothing there. Sports, maybe you start like a golf store, you can sell clothing around there. So within clothing is just an area where, you know, there's a lot of items being sold, but within that area itself, you can branch off to different industries and spaces and different niches. Besides apparel, we also have accessories. Now, when it comes to accessories, these can be different things like watches, rings, anything, any kind of accessories, phone cases. The second top selling space, you know, on their platform was accessories. So you guys can see, obviously, that's a huge space you guys can get into. Again, this is, you know, more than just a niche itself, it's an area where you guys can choose an actually specific niche and sell specific products. For example, if you're gonna sell accessories, a niche you can get into, or if you're gonna have a general store, you can sell men's watches, right? That's a huge space. The third most top selling items were houseware items. And when it comes to houseware items, again, you can either have a general store, or you can have a niche store based around these. And, you know, houseware items can be, I know there was a few, you know, a few weeks back or some time ago, I don't know if it's still trending, I would have to double check, but there was a pancake maker that was absolutely huge in the space and they were doing absolutely insane. I saw multiple ads of this pancake maker, and I think I've actually got hit with one recently, but there was a huge pancake maker. I've seen this, you know, salad cutter that did really well. You know, there's a ton of different household goods that you guys can test out. And again, these household goods can be anything. You also have shoes. I've had not too much experience with shoes, but I've seen some stores that, you know, have sold shoes. It is, again, a possibility for you guys. You have makeup. We've tested makeup, and you guys can find different spaces with team that you can have like a general makeup store or a specific, you know, makeup store. And you can look these things up. Like, these are real store, like these are statistics, right, coming from Shopify. So of course, if they're, you know, releasing this data, it's for a reason. You have electronics. We've never messed around with electronics. We figured that electronics sometimes are a little bit tougher, but again, that's just, you know, we haven't tested too many electronics, so you guys can definitely still test them. You have food. Again, within the food space, it doesn't have to necessarily be selling food. You can sell food accessories, right? You can sell different food things, like we mentioned, like household goods. So that's another space where it looks like they had a lot of top selling items. And the last one, you have games. Within the gaming space, you can also sell, you know, gaming accessories, gaming clothing, all these different things you guys can test out. You know, when it comes down to it, you know, finding these hot niches or niches that are really profitable, it all comes down to just doing the research, right? You want to just take the time, make sure you're spending the time. I actually have a video that if you guys haven't already, you can check out based on, you know, how you can do your product research. You guys can check out that video to see how I do my product research, but it's just a matter of really testing and finding a lot of different products. And also you can research different niches. What I like to do is, you know, personally for me, I like to research. Now, usually when I'm researching products, I like to also research, you know, related products and other products within that niche. That way I can see what kind of scalability that niche may have. Because if you're limited now to a specific niche where you can only sell maybe 3 or 4 products, you can see how that can become an issue later on, right? So I look for usually niches that have multiple products that I think could sell really well. Usually a lot of complementary products for upsells, downsells that I can remarket and send offers later on through emails and a lot more. That's pretty much, you know, what I wanted to kind of go over with you guys. This wasn't meant to be like a, you know, crazy long video. I can let you know that one of the best ways you guys can find, you know, a niche that's gonna be profitable for you is by simply testing, right? You have to test. But usually, you know, if this data is coming specifically from Shopify, this is an article, again, you guys can look at their website to find. And they're literally, you know, revealing a lot of the things that are selling the most. So based on this data, I'd recommend you guys find niches within these top selling kind of products. And, you know, look for different products around this space. Obviously, if they've already sold well before, this is actually expected to be a bigger, even bigger year. So obviously they probably sell even better. So if you guys got any value from this video, make sure you leave me a thumbs up again. And also, you know, leave me some comments. Let me know, you know, if you guys have tried out any of these niches again, where you've had some success. If you have any other questions, you know, in regards to how else you can pick a niche or how to test within a different niche or anything like that, you know, leave me a comment below. I'll try to respond to as many of you guys as possible. And if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button, join the VFAM, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.